Jermyn Street likes to think of itself as the best-known posh spot to shop in the world. It claims more royal warrants than any other London street. For 6 days this week, it'll be celebrating a history of craftsmanship as visitors are invited to view the backroom skills that produce its famous wares. Jermyn Street, which fashioned the Roaring Twenties, still manages to serve an exclusive world of those who can afford to get their food, shoes, cigars, and even their aftershave made there.
Well, we're a very staid lot, really, in Jermyn Street, and it's all yes, madam, no, madam, and the customer is still always right. But just once a year, for a week, rather like a holiday, we go absolutely crazy, you see, and have a spiffing time.
There'll be exhibitions of shirt making, and later in the week, even an ex-American president, fresh from the Moor Park Bob Hope Golf Classic. But today's star to open the week of 20s fun is a famous lollipop person.
I think it's a good cause, and it gives me a chance to catch my breath now that I've arrived in London 15 minutes ago.
Can you still afford to shop in Jermyn Street?
I don't know. Well, let's see. The pound is getting stronger and the dollar's getting weaker. I think we'll buy a shirt or two while I'm here.
You don't go to the hairdressers in Jermyn Street, then?
Well, luckily, I save all my money there so I can go shopping on Jermyn Street. No barbershops here.
Can I ask you a rude question? Right. Is it really bald or is it shaved?
I got a lot of face to shave in the morning. I just keep going, okay? I don't stop at the beard, I go to the head as well.
And why do the women here find it sexy, do you think?
Baby, you're asking the wrong guy. You got to ask the women.
Money raised will go to the Stars Organisation for Spastics and will come from autograph hunters chasing the stars who'll walk the street and the profits from a fashion show later in the week. Either way, the organisers hope that the proceeds will be sky high. Michael Wilson in Jermyn Street for Thames News.